Hi guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you another doily project. This time it's gonna be square doily with by using two colors. So it's completely up to you. You can manage with one color as well. My doily is measured about 14 and a half inches, so each side is exactly the same. I am using crochet hook size 1.5 millimeters and the thread similar to size 10. 50 gram equals about 280 meters. For this project we are going to use even less than 50 gram. So one ball supposed to be completely enough. This project we can make as a bigger one by joining center double crochets later on. So we've got three double crochets per each chain space. So the second one we can join, and then in this way we can attach squares together to make bigger project as well. I would like to thank you very much to all my sponsors, so to all my members of the channel, and to my old patrons for supporting my channel. It means really a lot to me. If you would like to join to members, you can go directly to my channel website, and next to the subscribe button you've got join button as well, or go to the Patreon site. So you can become a patron as well. You will get an access to more video tutorials which are dedicated directly to the members and sponsors of my channel. Now let's get started. Our rand, we are going to start by making slip knot, then chain of 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Slip stitch into the first chain stitch to form a ring, and now we are going to start our first round. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain 3 as a chain 3 space. Now into our circle we are going to make another 7 double crochets and chain 3 after each one. Double crochet in next chain 3, double crochet as the next, so we've got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and the last chain 3. 8 double crochets, 8 chain 3 spaces, and we need to work slip stitch in our third chain stitch of the first double crochet. Second round we are going to start by making slip stitch in our first chain 3 space. Now chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into the chain space we are going to make another 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then we have to skip double crochet, and in next chain 3 space another 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then again in next chain 3 space 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. In each chain 3 space we need to work 5 double crochets, so in total we should have 40 double crochets, and after our last one we have to work slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Now we are going to start third round, and after slip stitch at the top of our first double crochet, now we need to make chain of 3 as a first double crochet as well, and then 1 double crochet in next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4 actually. So we should have first group of 5 double crochets as we've done in first chain stitch. After this group, we need to work chain 1, then 1 double crochet in next 5 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, and 5, and then chain 1 again. So between each group of 5 double crochets, we are going to make 1 chain stitch, so 1 chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then chain 1. And this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. So we should have make 8 groups of 5 double crochets and 8 chain 1 spaces. Round number 4. After slip stitch in our first double crochet, we need to start with chain of 3 as a double crochet again, then 1 double crochet in the same stitch. 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Then 2 double crochets in last one. So in first double crochet we need to work 2 double crochets and into the last one 2 double crochets. So we should have group of 7 double crochets in a row. Now chain 1 and we have to continue in exactly the same way. In first double crochet, so we've got another group of 5 double crochets. In first double crochet we have to work 2 double crochets. Then 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets. One more time. 1, 2, and 3, and 2 double crochets in last one. 1 and 2. Chain 1, then in next group of 5 double crochets you have to repeat exactly the same. 2 double crochets in first one, 1 double crochet in next 3, and 2 double crochets in last one. So now we are going to continue the same pattern all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 5. And again, chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 6 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we've got group of 7 double crochets again. Now chain of 2. So instead of chain of 1, now we need to work chain of 2. And then 1 double crochet in next 7 double crochets again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Chain of 2, and again we have to skip chain 1 space and into the next 7 double crochets, 1 double crochet in each stitch, and then chain of 2. So we should have 8 groups of 7 double crochets and 8 chain 2 spaces. Now we are going to start round number 6 by making chain of 3 as the first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 2 stitches. 1 and 2. In our fourth double crochet, so the center one, we need to work V stitch. Double crochet, chain 1, and another double crochet. Then in our last 3 double crochets we have to work 1 double crochet in each stitch. 1, 2, entry. Now chain one again. So in our previous round we've done chain of two, now we have to go back to our chain one space, and in next group of seven double crochets we have to repeat exactly the same. So one double crochet in first three double crochets, 1, 2 and 3. Then into the fourth double crochet we have to make double crochet, chain one and another double crochet. One double crochet in next three double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. So in each fourth double crochet of each group we have to work this stitch, double crochet, chain one and double crochet. In the first three and the last three double crochets we have to work one double crochet in each stitch, and then chain one. So now this pattern we are going to repeat all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 7. So chain of three as the first double crochet, and now into the next three double crochets we have to work one double crochet in each stitch. 1, 2 and 3. So we are exactly in our first double crochet of the V-stitch from the previous round. Now chain of 5. Then we are going to skip our chain 1 space, and in next 4 double crochets, 1 double crochet in each stitch. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now chain 1. And we are going to repeat one double crochet in our four first double crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4. And we've got chain one space again. Now chain of 5, 4 and 5, and one double crochet in next four double crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain 1. And this is our whole pattern for this round. So at the end, after the last chain 1 space, we have to work slip stitch in first double crochet. Now we've got round number 8. And we are going to start this round by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then double crochet into the next double crochet. In our last two double crochets we have to work two double crochets together. So through first two loops one time, the last loop need to stay on the hook, and into the next double crochet exactly the same. When we've got three loops on our hook we need to finish the stitch. So two double crochets together. Chain of 5. Then single crochet in chain 5 space. Chain 5. Then into the first two double crochets after our chain 5 space we have to again work two double crochets together. So in two double crochets before and two double crochets after. So through first two loops, last loop need to stay on the hook, and again through first two loops. When we've got three loops we can finish the stitch. Now one double crochet in next two double crochets. In our previous round we had chain one space. Now we have to go directly to the next two double crochets without any chain stitches, and another one double crochet in each stitch. And from now we need to repeat what we've done from the beginning of our round. So in two double crochets before chain 5 space we need to make two double crochets together. Then chain of 5. Single crochet in chain 5 space, chain of 5, and in our first two double crochets after chain 5 space, two double crochets together again, then one double crochet in next three double crochets, two. Now we have to skip chain 1 space, into the next two double crochets, one double crochet again, and in next two double crochets together. then chain 5 single crochet and another chain 5. So this pattern now we need to repeat all the way around. Round number 9. We are going to start by making chain of 3 as the first double crochet, and now into the next 2 stitches we have to work 2 double crochets together. So at the end of our group we've done 2 double crochets together. So this is count now as a only one stitch. So we have to work first part of the double crochet in our first double crochet and first part of the double crochet in next. So now we've got 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 3, single crochet in chain 5 space. Now chain 5, single crochet in next chain space, chain of 3. Then in first 2 stitches we need to work 2 double crochets together. So last loop need to stay on the hook each time. In next 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet, so 1 and 1, and in next 2, 2 double crochets together again. So basically we've got 4 stitches in a row. So this is mean that at the end of our run we are going to make 2 double crochets together, then the last double crochet and slip stitch into the third chain stitch. And now we have to make chain of 3 again, single crochet in first chain space, chain 5, single crochet in next chain space, then chain of 3 and again. So this pattern now we have to continue all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 11. So our round, we need to start from the beginning, so from the stitch where we've done 2 double crochets together. So we need to drop our loop, then work slip stitch into the previous double crochet. And slip stitch in our 2 double crochets together from the beginning. So I know this is quite hard, but this is the best way to start from this stitch, because we are going to make 4 double crochets together. So chain of 2 as the first part of the double crochet, then into the next 3 stitches. I know that this part can be quite hard now because we've done slip stitch before, so we need to insert crochet hook in any stitch just in exactly the same, in the same line as our stitch. So through first 2 loops, then into the next third stitch and into our fourth stitch as well. So we should have 4 loops on our hook now, 4 first parts of the double crochets and 4 loops. Now we can finish the stitch. Chain of 7, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now we have to skip chain 3 space. In our chain 5 we are going to make single crochet, chain 5 and 1 more single crochet. Chain of 7 again. And now we have to skip next chain 3 space. We've got another 4 double crochets and we are going to make 4 double crochets together again. So only the first part of the double crochet in each stitch. Now we should have 5 loops on our hook and we can finish the stitch, 1 extra because we've done chain space before. And this is our first corner. So here is the side, and in each second group of 4 double crochets together we need to work corners. So we are going to make chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Then we have to insert our crochet hook in all loops as we finish our stitch and work slip stitch. So chain of 10. Now chain of 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Slip stitch again in exactly the same way, so we need to insert crochet hook in all 4, 5 loops and work slip stitch. I know this is again a little bit hard, and one more time, as I said, a little bit hard, and one more time we need to work chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Once again, slip stitch in all our loops. So chain of 10, then chain of 16, and chain of 10 again. Now chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we are going to continue with the same pattern, and we have to skip chain 3, single crochet in chain 5, then chain of 5, single crochet in the same chain space, chain of 7, and again we have to skip chain 3 space. In next group we have to make only 4 double crochets together without any chain stitches. So in every second group we are working the corner, so exactly what we've done few seconds before. So now you can easily see how this pattern looks like. At the top of our 4 double crochets together we've got chain of 10, chain of 16, and another chain of 10. Now we've got the normal group of 4 double crochets together, and again chain of 7. So we are continue the pattern from the beginning. We have to skip chain 3, now single crochet in chain 5, chain 5, single crochet in the same chain stitch, chain of 7, and in next group we are going to make 4 double crochets together first, and in this one we need to repeat our pattern with chain 10, chain 16, and chain 10 again. So we should have 4 groups without our loops and 4 groups with. So this is exactly the corner, our first corner, now the second, then third, and fourth in last group of this round. And at the end, after the last chain of 7, we need to work slip stitch at the top of our 3 double crochets together, so chain 2 space we have to skip. Then we can fasten off and cut the yarn. From the next round I'm going to use the white color. Now we are going to start round number 12, and by using the another color I'm going to join at the top of my group of 4 double crochets together. So I'm going to make chain 1 and then single crochet, so the tail we can hide a little bit later. After single crochet, chain of 8, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Single crochet in chain 5 space, then chain of 8 again, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Single crochet in chain 10 space, chain of 8, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Single crochet in chain 16 space, chain of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Single crochet in next chain 10 space, chain of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So we are always making chain 8 spaces. Now we have to skip chain 7, single crochet in chain 5, chain of 8 again, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and single crochet at the top of the next 4 double crochets together. And from now we are going to repeat. So as I said, we have to work chain of 8 all the time, and we need to work single crochet in chain 5 space, then in chain 10 space, in chain 16 space, in chain 10 space, then in chain 5 space, and at the top of each group of 4 double crochets together. Now we've got round number 13 and we are going to start with chain 1 and single crochet in our first single crochet. Now we have to work one single crochet in each chain stitch, so in our chain 8 space we should have 8 single crochets. If you have problem with working exactly in each chain space, you can make 8 single crochets directly into the chain space, but in this way I think it will be looks much better. So let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, then single crochet into next single crochet. I'm going to double check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 now. And the same in next chain space, so one single crochet in each chain stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and the 8th one is over here. So sometimes it's quite hard to insert crochet hook in the proper stitch, and single crochet into the single crochet. Once again, one single crochet in next 8 chain stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and into the last one, the 8th. And now we've got our single crochet exactly at the corner, so at the top of our chain 16 space, and in our, at the corner we are going to make 3 single crochets. 1, 2 and 3. So only at the corners we are working 3 single crochets in each stitch, then one single crochet in each chain stitch and one single crochet in each single crochet from our previous round. And by working this pattern we have to continue all the way around. Round number 14. We are going to start by making slip stitch in next 3 single crochets. So at the moment we are going to skip our first 2 single crochets, but at the end of our round we have to continue the pattern. I'm going to show you a little bit later. So our round, we are going to start with chain of 4 as a first treble crochet, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space. Now we need to skip next 2 single crochets, 1 treble crochet in third one, chain of 2, then again we have to skip next 2 single crochets, treble crochet in third one. So exactly into the, in a single crochet as we've done into the single crochet, and we have to continue. So chain of 2, then we need to skip next 2 single crochets, treble crochet in third, chain of 2, again we need to skip next 2, treble crochet in third, chain of 2, then we need to skip next 2, treble crochet into the third. So what I would like to show you, per each group of 8 single crochets we should have 3 open big squares. Because we had to skip our first 2 single crochets, in our first part we've got only 2, but at the end of our round we need to work double crochet into the treble crochet into the first single crochet of this round. And then we need to skip the next 2 single crochets, so as we've done slip stitch already, and work slip stitch in 4th chain stitch. So basically we need to add extra square at the end as well. So per each 8 single crochets we have to make 3 open squares until the corner. At the corner it looks a little bit different. So now let's go to the corner. Chain of 2. And now treble crochet in third single crochet, chain 2, treble crochet in first single crochet, chain two, then treble crochet in third single crochet. And this is actually our first single crochet at the corner. So as you remember, we've done three single crochets at the corner in one stitch. So now after the first treble crochet, so after the treble crochet in first single crochet at the corner, we are going to make chain of four, not chain of two, but chain of four, and then treble crochet into the second single crochet, so directly to the next one. Then chain of four again and treble crochet into our third single crochet, so again to the next one. Only at the corner we have to work treble crochet in each single crochet, and after first and second we need to work chain four spaces. So at the corner we've got two chain four spaces, and the rest of our side we are working with chain two. So now we are going back, chain of two again, then we have to skip now our next two single crochets, treble crochet into the third one, and then chain of two. Now we have to skip next two single crochets, treble crochet into the third one, chain of two, skip the next two single crochets, treble crochet into the third one, and we have to continue this pattern until the next corner. So as I said, three open squares per each group of eight single crochets, and at the corner we have to work treble crochet in each single crochet and two chain four spaces. So now don't forget to add extra square at the end and work slip stitch in fourth chain stitch of our first treble crochet. Now we are going to start round number 15. So after our last treble crochet in exactly the same single crochet as we actually finished the round with single crochets, then we had to work chain two and slip stitch into the fourth chain stitch of our first treble crochet. Now we need to start with chain three as a double crochet, chain one as a chain one space, and double crochet in next in the same stitch. So you've got V stitch in our first treble crochet. Now chain of six, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we have to skip next treble crochet into the next one V stitch again, so into the second one, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Then chain of six again, 3, 4, 5, 6. This time we have to skip two treble crochets and V stitch into the third one. Double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Chain of six again, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now again, we have to skip one treble crochet into the next one, V stitch, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Chain of six. So always we are working with chain six, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And now we've got three treble crochets as we've done at the corner. The first one we have to skip, and then chain four space we need to skip as well. Into the second we have to make three double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. So three double crochets without any chain spaces, and we are going to repeat. So chain of six, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and now the same as we've done on our opposite side, we need to skip next treble crochet and into the second V stitch, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Basically the pattern, what we need to repeat is that in two places in our side, on each side we have to skip two times two treble crochets. The rest we are working with skipping only one. So in total on each side we should have eight V stitches. So I'm going to show you how to make the whole this side, and the rest you can continue in exactly the same way. So now chain of six again, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we need to skip first treble crochet into the next one double crochet, chain one, and then double crochet, chain of six, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and now We are going to skip two treble crochets, V-stitch into the third one. So double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Chain of six. Now we have to skip one treble crochet into the second double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet, so V-stitch again. So far we've got four. Chain of six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now we have to skip one into the next one V-stitch, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Chain of six. So now we are going to skip two treble crochets. One, two, three, four, five, and six. So we've done one time before. Now is the second. One and two into the third one V stitch. Double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Chain of six. Three, four, five, and six. Then we have to skip one treble crochet into the second V stitch. Double crochet, chain one, and then double crochet, chain of six, one, two, three, four, five, and six. Now we have to skip next one and into the second V stitch, double crochet, chain one, and then double crochet. And we are before our next corner right now. So the same as we've done before, we have to work chain of six, three, four, five, and six. And now we have to skip first treble crochet into the second, so into exactly at the corner we have to work three double crochets. One, two, and three. Then chain of six, and we have to repeat what we done before. So basically the pattern we can keep like that. So first one we are going to skip only one, then next two, then three times, then two times only one, next two, and the last two times only one treble crochet. So make sure that you've got eight V stitches on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and eight, and at each corner we've got three double crochets, and all the time we are working with chain six spaces. Now we've got round number 16, and we have to start by making slip stitch in chain one space, and then chain of three as a first double crochet, chain one, and one more double crochet in the same chain space. So we've got V stitch in our V stitch, chain of six, three, four, five, and six. Then we have to go directly to the next V stitch, and we need to work exactly the same. So another V stitch, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet, chain of six, three, four, five, and six. Then we need to go to the next V stitch, and we are working another one. So double crochet, chain one, and double crochet, chain of six, one, two, three, four, five, six, and V stitch into the next V stitch. So in this round we have to work with chain six spaces again, and we are working V stitch in each V stitch from our previous round. So again we should have eight V stitches. Now chain of six, three, four, five, six, and we are exactly at the corner. We've got three double crochets. In first one we have to work V stitch again, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Then chain of four, one, two, three, and four, and into the second double crochet we need to work one treble crochet, two, and three. So exactly at the corner we've got treble crochet, then chain of four, and V stitch into the next double crochet, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Now chain of six, one, two, three, four, five, and six, and we have to go to the next V stitch, then V stitch again, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. So from now we need to repeat all the time we are working with chain six spaces and V stitch in each V stitch until the next corner. So at each corner in first double crochet we need to work V stitch, chain four, then treble crochet, chain 4, and another V-stitch. And this pattern we have to repeat all the way around. Now we've got round 17. So our round we have to start in exactly the same way. We are going to start with V-stitch in our first V-stitch, then chain 6, and V-stitch in next all V-stitches, even the V-stitch at the corner. After that V-stitch, before our chain 4 space and treble crochet, we are going to make chain of 6 again. So in our last one round we had chain 4, now chain 6 again, and into the treble crochet now we need to work 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Now chain of 6 again, 3, 4, 5 and 6, then V-stitch into the next V-stitch, double crochet, chain 1 and double crochet, and from now we need to repeat our pattern. So chain 6 and V-stitch into each V-stitch. So only at the corner in treble crochet we need to work 3 double crochets, and we've got chain 6 spaces on both sides. Now we are going to start round number 18. Basically I've done already my first 5 V-stitches, so the pattern is staying exactly the same. So we've got a V-stitch, chain 6, V-stitch, chain 6, and basically the pattern is changing only at the corners all the time. So after our last 5th V-stitch I've done chain 6 space again, and we've got 3 double crochets at the corner. In first one we are going to make another V-stitch, so double crochet, chain 1 and then double crochet. Now chain of 6. So 2 rows before we've done chain of 4, but now we are going to make chain of 6. Then treble crochet into the second double crochet, chain of 6 again, and V-stitch into the next double crochet, chain 1, and then another double crochet. Now chain of 6 again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, into the next V-stitch, V-stitch again, and from now we are going to repeat the pattern as we are making all the time. So chain 6 and V-stitch in each V-stitch to the next corner. So at the corner in first double crochet we've got V-stitch, chain 6, treble crochet, chain 6 and another V-stitch. So now we are going to continue this pattern all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 19. So we need to go to the chain 1 space and we are making chain 3 as a double crochet, then chain 1, double crochet into the same stitch, chain 1, then double crochet still in the same stitch. So in our first V-stitch we've got 3 double crochets and 2 chain 1 spaces. Now chain of 1, then we have to go to our chain 6 space and we are going to make 5 single crochets. 2, 3, 4 and 5. Single crochet in double crochet, single crochet in chain 1 space, then single crochet in next double crochet. In next chain space 5 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then chain 1 and we are going to repeat. So we have to work 3 double crochets in next V-stitch and 2 chain 1 spaces. So double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, chain 1 and another double crochet. Now chain of 1 and 5 single crochets in next chain space, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Single crochet in double crochet, single crochet in chain 1 space, then single crochet in next double crochet. And again we have to work 5 single crochets in next chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Chain 1 and in next V-stitch again we have to work 3 double crochets. So as you can see in each second V-stitch we are going to repeat this. Double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, chain one, and one more double crochet, chain one, then 5 single crochets in chain space, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, single crochet in the in double crochet, single crochet in chain one space, and single crochet in next double crochet. Now in our last chain space before the corner, again we are going to make 5 single crochets, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now chain one, and into our treble crochet at, exactly at the corner, we have to work again double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Now chain one, and we have to make 5 single crochets in our next chain space, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, single crochet into the double crochet, single crochet in chain space, and single crochet into the next double crochet. So the pattern is actually quite easy, but in a, because we've got 12 V stitches, we are going to change the pattern in the center a little bit, so that's why I still need to show you what we have to do next. So at the moment it looks exactly the same as we've done it before. So in one, at the corner we had 3 double crochets, so the into the first V stitch we've got single crochets, and now in next one 3 double crochets, so double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet. Now chain one, and into the next chain space we have to work 5 single crochets again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, single crochet in double crochet, single crochet in chain one space, single crochet in next double crochet, and then 5 single crochets in next chain space, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, chain one, then in next V stitch again double crochet, chain one, then double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet. So this is our second group, chain one. Now we have to make 5 single crochets in next chain space, 3, 4, and 5, single crochet in double crochet, single crochet into the chain one space, and single crochet in next double crochet. Now 5 single crochets in next chain space, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, chain one, in chain one space double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet. So now we are exactly in the center, so this is actually our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th in chain space, and after third group with 3 double crochets and 2 chain one spaces, now we have to work chain one, and into the next chain space only 3 single crochets, 1, 2, and 3. Now chain of one, and into the next V stitch again double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet. So this is actually the same part as we just started our round. So from now we are going to make another 2 more repeat. So this is the first one, then we are going to make the second and the third just before the corner. So that's why I had to show you how to make the pattern till the center of each side. So this is mean that by continue this pattern, at the end we have to make the last group of 3 double crochets in our last V stitch and only 3 single crochets in last chain space. So now we need to continue all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 20. So after slip stitch in our first double crochet, now we are going to start with chain 4 as a treble crochet, then chain 3 as a chain 3 space. Treble crochet into the next double crochet. Chain 3, then treble crochet in the same double crochet. So into the center, into the second one, we have to work 2 treble crochets, chain of 3, then treble crochet in last double crochet. Now chain of 3, then we have to skip 7. Then we have to skip 6 single crochets and into the 7th, so exactly into the single crochet in chain 1 space, we have to work single crochet, chain of 3, then we have to skip another 6 single crochets and we are going directly to the next 3 double crochets. Treble crochet into the first one, then chain of 3, treble crochet into the second, chain of 3, treble crochet again into the second, chain 3, then treble crochet into the third. Now chain of 3, then single crochet into the seventh single crochet again, so exactly in the center of our V stitch, chain of 3 and again. So treble crochet into the first double crochet, chain 3, treble crochet into the next one, chain 3, treble crochet in the same, so into the second, chain 3, then treble crochet into the third. Now chain of 3, single crochet in chain 1 space, chain of 3, and now we are exactly at the corner. So at the corner in each double crochet we are going to make 2 treble crochets. So we are going to start with the first one, then chain 3, now second, chain 3, then into the second double crochet again, first one, chain 3, then second, chain 3, and into the third one again, treble crochet, chain 3, and another treble crochet. Now chain of 3, then again, we have to skip 6 single crochets and single crochet into the 7th, chain of 3, then we have to skip another 6 single crochets and into the first one treble crochet, and then we have to repeat what we've done from the beginning. So on the sides we've got 4 treble crochets per group and at the corner 6. So at the end we should have one more group of 4 treble crochets and we need to work slip stitch into the 4th chain stitch of our first treble crochet. Now we are going to start the last one around round 21. And we have to start with a slip stitch in first chain 3 space, then chain of 2 instead of our first half double crochet. Into the same chain space now we are going to make another 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3, then one more half double crochet. So half double crochet, 3 double crochets and another half double crochet. Into the next chain space, the same. Half double crochet, 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3 and another half double crochet. Into the next, again. Half double crochet, 3 double crochets, 2 and 3 and another half double crochet. In chain 3 space, before and after single crochet, we have to work 5 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 single crochets in next chain space, so single crochet we need to skip. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then we've got chain 3 spaces between treble crochets. So the pattern is with half double crochet, then 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3, and another half double crochet. So basically all the way around we've done chain 3 spaces, but as you can see already we've got some differences. So in each chain 3 space between treble crochets we have to work with half double crochet, and another half double crochet. So even at the corner, but at the corner instead of 3 chain 3 spaces we've got 5. But the pattern is staying exactly the same. Half double crochet, 3 double crochets, and another half double crochet. But in each chain 3 space, before and after single crochet, we need to work with 5 single crochets as we've done here. And that's it. So at the end, after our last single crochet, we are going to make slip stitch in the second chain of our first half double crochet. Then we can fasten off and cut the yarn, and our doily will be done. At the end we can use hot iron to make this project more flat. We can even block this project to make it more flat as well. And basically that's it. So if you would like to this type of project, just let me in the comment section below, put your thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you are new on my channel. I wish you a nice day and see you in the next video.